Captain Solo.
Mike!
Sir, might I suggest that you... It can wait.
This bucket of bolts is never going to get us past that blockade.
This baby's got a few surprises left in her, sweetheart.
Come on, come on!
Switch over. Let's hope we don't have a burnout.
Someday
you're gonna be wrong, and I just hope I'm
able to see it. Punch it! Here they come.
No
That's it! We did it!
We did it!
Help! I think I'm melting. This is all your fault.
Stay sharp. There's two more coming in. They're going to try and cut us off.
Why don't you outrun them? I thought you said this thing was fast.
Watch your mouth, kid. You're going to find yourself floating home.
We'll be safe enough once we make the jump to hyperspace. Besides, I know a few maneuvers. We'll lose them. So the fun begins.
How long before you can make the jump to light speed?
Take a few moments to get the coordinates from the navicomputer.
Are you kidding? At the rate they're gaining?
Traveling through hyperspace ain't like dusting crops, boy. Without precise calculations, we'd fly right through a star or bounce too close to a supernova, and that'd end your trip real quick, wouldn't it?
What's that flashing?
We're losing a deflector shield.
Both strap yourselves in. I'm going to make the jump to light speed.
Why don't we just go into light speed? You can't. How would you know the hyperdrive is deactivated? The city's central computer told you. R2-D2, you know better than to trust a strange computer. Ouch! Pay attention to what you're doing! R2, come back at once! You haven't finished with me yet! You don't know how to fix the hyperdrive. Chewbacca can do it! I'm standing here in pieces, and you're having delusions of grandeur! You did it!
Are you all right? What's wrong?
I felt a great disturbance in the Force, as if millions of voices suddenly cried out in terror and were suddenly silenced. I fear something terrible has happened. You better get on with your exercises.
Well, you can forget your troubles with those Imperial slugs. I told you I'd outrun them.
Don't everybody thank me at once. Anyway, we should be at all around about 0200 hours.
Now be careful, R2. You made a fair move. Screaming about it can't help you.
I don't have it. It's not wise to upset a Wookiee.
But, sir, nobody worries about upsetting a droid.
It's because a droid don't pull people's arms out of their sockets when they lose. Wookiees are known to do that.
I see your point, sir. I suggest a new strategy, R2. Let the Wookiee win.
Remember, a Jedi can feel the Force flowing through him.
You mean he controls your actions?
Partially, but it also obeys your commands.
Pokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
You don't believe in the Force, do you?
Kid, I've flown from one side of this galaxy to the other. I've seen a lot of strange stuff, but I've never seen anything to make me believe there's one all-powerful Force controlling everything. There's no mystical energy field controls my destiny. It's all a lot of simple tricks and nonsense.
I suggest you try it again, Luke. This time, let go your conscious self and act on instinct.
With the blast shield down, I can't even see. How am I supposed to fight?
Your eyes can deceive you. Don't trust them. Stretch out with your feelings.
Yeah.
see? You can do it.
I call it luck.
In my experience, there's no such thing as luck.
Look, good against remotes is one thing. Good against the living, that's something else. Looks like we're coming up on Alderaan.
You know, I did feel something. I could almost see the remote.
That's good. You've taken your first step into a larger world.
Wait! Oh my! What have you done? I'm backwards! You sleep-bitten furball! Only an overgrown mophead like you would be stupid enough!
You don't know the power of the dark side.